Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the 45th President of the United States, Donald J. Trump.
Regulation cuts, fair trade, strong borders, and American energy independence. It's a vote to support our police, support our military, defend our Second Amendment. Stand up to China. And as your war products are proudly stamped with that beautiful phrase. You know what the phrase is? Made in the USA. We will deliver record prosperity, epic job growth, and a safe vaccine is coming very quickly. You're going to have it momentarily. That eradicates the virus, and we're rounding the turn regardless of how we got the vaccine. I say regardless, I'll say, well, maybe you don't. We have it. Great companies. And quickly ends the pandemic. Should have never come here from China. They should have never let it happen. We'll never forget. All over the world. You see what's happening in Europe. All over the world. Normal life will fully resume. That's what we want, right? And next year will be the greatest economic year in the history of our country. A vote for Sleepy Joe Biden. He is a sleepy guy, I tell you. It's a powerful party, and the party is totally joined with the fake news media, the lamestream media right there. And they're totally joined with the big tech. I don't know, Section 230. Does anyone know what Section 230 is? Section 230, I think, wow. You know, tremendous corruption on behalf of the Biden. Tremendous. Do you know you can't find it anywhere in the media other than the New York Post, which I heard from, that they endorsed you the other day. But you can't find it anywhere in the media, anywhere. It's not on any of the, it's not in Facebook. They have trending. They always put me trending. They'll give you 25 things that I've done over my life. They make it negative, always negative trending. But Sleepy Joe Biden, with all the corruption, all the theft, all the money they took out of these countries that we end up paying for in spades, you can't find it in Big Tech, and you can't find it in the Washington Post, the New York Times, because they're crooked, they're dishonest, and we caught them. We caught them just like we caught them spying in our campaign. Just like we caught them spying in our campaign. For the biggest tax hike in the history of our country. This is the only guy I've ever seen. He's campaigning because he has no clue. He's shot, just so you understand. And I'll say it. Because I've said, hey, I've seen enough. Here's a guy gets caught and the media doesn't want to write about it. You know what they call it? Not freedom of the press, suppression of the press. We don't have freedom of the press. You know what? We don't have, you understand that? We don't have freedom of the press. We have suppression of the press, and there's never been a time when it's more obvious than right now. Is that right? Is that right, John? He wants crushing regulation. He, by the way, he has no idea where he is. They carried him off the stage yesterday. These people grabbed him. Get him off! Get him off! He's trying to make it to the finish line. I mean, it's a disgrace. The whole thing is a con job. Should have never been the candidate. And you know what? They have a corrupt party. And all of this work being done by big tech and being done by the media, that should be considered a major, massive, billion-dollar campaign contribution, because that's what it is. They slashed Medicare and Social Security. He wants to knock out your Medicare, your Social Security. And he wants to abolish a thing called American energy. You see that, right? No fracking. There'll be no fracking. No, for a year he's going, no fracking. He gets the nomination. He goes to Pennsylvania. They tell him, Joe, you have to change. Oh, okay, what do you want me to say? I love fracking. Say I love. So he goes from no fracking, I love fracking. A vote for Sleepy Joe Biden is a vote for open borders, offshoring jobs, shredding your Second Amendment, which is totally under siege. You're so lucky I'm your president. Super recovery and a Biden depression. You will have a depression, the likes of which you haven't seen before, maybe 1929. Once the Raisins Act is put regulations back on. Remember this, get rid of the Second Amendment. Remember this. Pro-life, anybody pro-life? This is the single biggest election, in my opinion, and I never thought I'd say it, in the history of our country. This is the biggest in the history of our country. It's a choice between a Trump boom and a Biden lockdown. He'll close it up. He'll close it up. It's really something. And you know, we talk about the American dream. We had the American dream. It was all coming together. There was going to be, believe it or not, unity. I was getting called from people, you wouldn't believe it. And then we had this thing come in, that came in very funny. The invisible enemy came in, and we went back to work, and we saved 2 million people. It was going to be 2.2 million people. We saved maybe more than that. But it's a choice between the American dream and a socialist nightmare. That's what it is. And the reason it's such important is because, you've heard me say it many times, our country will never be a socialist country. Dreams of all Americans, including millions of truly amazing Hispanic Americans. Who's this guy? Who's this guy? Oh, they're shocked. They don't believe it. You know, the polls with Hispanics are through the roof. They're reporting on it. They said, I never had a problem. I always liked Hispanic, but they're getting to understand me and the incredible progress that they've made. So the polls with Hispanic Americans or the highest ever in the history of our country for a Republican, but it could be that we're going to top them. And once we top them, you're going to forget about them because we've really gotten along. The poll, by the way, who saw the debate the other night? Anybody? You see the poll, 91-9. 91-9, that's not bad. I got angry at the media. I thought it should have been better than that. And I felt like Perry Mason because he admitted right at the end this last thing. I said, does that mean you don't like oil, Joe? That was Perry Mason. You ever watch? Huh? Columbo. How about Columbo? Right at the end. Does that mean, how did he blow? They've been working for 5 days and then they had to go to Pennsylvania where fracking's a big deal. Huh? How about Texas? You think they like it in Texas? No oil. Think of this. No oil, no gun, Second Amendment. No God, religion. And then I hear Trump has a 1-point lead in Texas. I don't think so. You know, I used to hear this 4 years ago all the time. He cannot win the great state of Ohio. He must win. We won by 8 points. Has never done this before. He cannot win Texas under no circumstances. He cannot win Texas. Remember Utah? We had the guy from Utah. He was a specialist in Utah. He was going to win Utah. He came in third. Even Crooked Hillary beat that guy. Remember Shapers? Nice shape, that nice guy. You remember his name? Yeah. He's one of the others. Another lineup. You know, we're against a lot. So I always act extremely innocent. They start scrolling. All I have to do is mention the name. Crooked, disgraceful, deplorable, irredeemable. You know, they said deplorable and irredeemable. Who would have thought her speech would have turned out to be? She came out, she said deplorable, but she also said irredeemable. And to show you what I know, I said, oh, she used the word irredeemable about our people. That's terrible. But it was deplorable, the court on it, right? But whoever her speechwriter is, I don't want him or her. That was a disaster. But I never thought it was going to be that bad. You know, the next day I showed up at a rally. Everybody said, I'm a deplorable. But she was a lot smarter than Sleepy Joe, but they've got a little bit different kind of a thing going on right now. They're more desperate, you know? They're more desperate. They're totally desperate. Because they have a candidate that they listen to ourselves. They took him off the stage yesterday, so he called me George. He thought I was George. He called me George! It's unbelievable. Yeah. I didn't know if I was happy or if I wasn't happy. Because he called me, his wife was sitting right next to him, and she's looking like, ha, I'm done. You could see she was under great, great stress. For the last 4 years, These suckers are moving like hell. I think let's go off this. You know? Isn't it nice to have a president that doesn't need a telegram? They are moving like crazy. They are moving like crazy. And that's okay with me. If Ronald Reagan, who I consider being top-notch, if he came here, he'd have a couple of hundred people legitimately. He'd go into a ballroom someplace inside, he'd go into a ballroom, and he'd have a 200-300 people. And that's what, you know, that's what the Senate would. We're having 25, 30, 35, 40, 45,000 people. And at least some of these crowds, we were packed in Florida and all these places. And I'd leave some of the crowds and I'd look at, now look at that, you can't even see the end, you can't even see. If they were legitimate, they'd show, they never show it on camera. They never show it on camera. They never ever show it. You don't like to show it. You know what they do show? Barack Hussein Obama yesterday, they made the mistake. The camera slipped. And they showed his crowd, he had about 20 people there, bro. Which was about 10 people more than Sleepy Joe had yesterday. You know, you saw, we were in Pennsylvania, right? You saw that. And we had three rallies, all in Pennsylvania. It was incredible. Thousands and thousands and thousands of people. And Joe was in his basement, but he saw it. And his handlers, much more importantly, saw it. They say, Sleepy Joe, we have to get you out of here. We got a movie in them, it's not looking good. Because, you know, they put a lid on, you know, a lid for a garbage can. This is for, that's where it comes from. They put a lid on. And he has a lid today. The guy's got lids every damn day. And then he said, he doesn't want to have big crowds. Really? Because of COVID. He has, he's such a great citizen. He's such a great guy. Then why did he cheat so much with Hunter? Where's Hunter, by the way? Where's Hunter? Where's Hunter? I remember we did the t-shirt, Where's Hunter? It's sold out. Now we have, it's called The Laptop from Hell. The Laptop from Hell. It's the greatest laptop I've ever seen. This thing is gold. It's gold, except for the news, it doesn't want to look at it. It refuses to look at it. It's the laptop from Hell. Except for Anthony Weiner, that was a long time. I would rate Anthony's maybe even worse. Anthony, that was not good. For the last 4 years, I've been delivering the Hispanic Americans a message like they haven't heard for a long time. I'm fighting for school choice, right? School choice, big deal. Safe neighborhoods, Hispanic-owned small businesses. We have great, great business people there. I know some of them. I've helped some of them. And I'm incredible. All these people don't know what the hell they're doing. Let me recover my ears for one second. Whoever did this microphone, don't pay them. When somebody does a lousy job, like a microphone that's no good, or like teleprompters that fly with the wind, I say, don't pay them. But we love our incredible Hispanic American members of law enforcement, and we have a lot of them. We achieved the lowest Hispanic in America, the lowest Hispanic American unemployment ever recorded, not even close. And we're getting back to those numbers again. The last number of months, 11.4 million a record people were hired. Joe Biden would obliterate every single thing that we've done. He's looking to do that. He's looking to obliterate our tax cuts. He wants to. So we gave tax cuts, the biggest in history. He wants to end the tax cuts. He wants to end the child tax credits. The $1,000 per child, he wants to end them. Wiping out your small businesses with lockdowns, regulations, gutting your police departments and devastating your families with a massive tax hike. I said, it's the biggest initiative. It's not gonna happen. You know why it's not gonna happen? Because he's not gonna win. We can't have him. People attack religious liberty and his running mate, the most liberal member of Congress. She makes Bernie Sanders look like a super conservative. I don't think she's for the people of Arizona or Nevada. And we want to know, who are the judicial nominees? Who are they? Who are you going to put on the court? You know, they want to pack the courts, right? How do you like our nominee? Amen. To ban charter schools, fund extreme late-term abortion. You know, what's the fuck? Late-term, even beyond late-term. You saw the governor of Virginia, the child is born, and then they make a decision as to execution of the child. You saw that, the governor of Virginia, Biden totally supports it, and surrender your country to the violent socialist mob. Take a look at Philadelphia last year. And we offered to go in, we'd stop that in 2 minutes. We offered to go in. And they said, stand back to the police. The police want to do their job. They don't want that to happen. They could, I think they endorsed me too, everybody, all police departments. That's why we are going to win a record share of Hispanic Americans, of African Americans, of Asian Americans. We're going to win a historic share of women. Remember last time? You will not get women. Well, it didn't work out that way, right? The end of the night, I don't know what happened. You got a lot of women. You did very well with women. You know why? Women are very smart. They want security. They want safety. If they're from suburbia, suburban women, they give me a hard time with suburban women. You know what they want? They want security, and they don't want their neighborhood destroyed. And I ended the regulation that would destroy their neighborhood. But I'm not just running against Joe Biden. I'm running against the left-wing mob and the left-wing media, the big tech giants. And I'm also running against the rhinos. You know what a rhino is? A rhino may be the lowest form of human life. I actually thought of like the others better than the rhinos, you know why? That plane's about 4 days old. We have all brand new equipment, F-35. We're the envy of the world. You know what? We are the envy. You know that back there? For the end, look at that sucker, he's trying to show off to the bus. That's one of ours, that's a good one. And they have nothing but disdain for you and for your values. They lecture you on open borders. By the way, we don't have one, they don't have open borders, you know. We're just now completing the wall, all we finished first in Mexico, where you came. They lecture you on everything. If a country doesn't, I love that sound. You don't know what I went through to get that. is an entertainment guy. They don't want to show anything that's good. But it was something. So they were trying to get our attention with the independent over here. And he got my attention, even though he was very high. But that was beautiful. Nobody in the world has the equipment. Love it! They support crippling lockdowns while their jobs remain totally exempt. They keep your kids out of school. And you know what they want to teach in school? We don't teach that in school. We get that. Their families that have private tutors. They want to take away your guns, your Second Amendment. The Second Amendment is so understood. But we're going to keep your Second Amendment. Nothing's going to be changed. I don't see the people of Arizona or Nevada. 19% of the people here from Nevada. Oh, don't worry. I just left Nevada, by the way. I'll be back there pretty soon. They all have armed guards. We got to tell these people, don't have armed guards. They don't want you to have... From now on, no more armed guards. Let's outlaw armed guards. You like that? How about Nancy Pelosi? She goes into San Francisco. And she wants to get her beautiful hair redone. And she ends up with a total Trump supporter as the owner of the beauty. I'm going to go and have my hair done by that woman. Seriously. With your vote, man, is it Whitney? Are you serious? I think it's from the F-35 that we just. With your vote, you can send the wealthy liberal hypocrites a message that they'll never forget. Under Biden's rule,
just favor that side of the box a bit. Yeah.
Countless Americans will die, and you know this, from suicide, drugs, deferred medical care. There's so many different things. The cure cannot be worse than the problem itself. Now it's not only opened up, but Nevada, get your governor to open up your state, please. Nevada, I don't know. Get him to open it up. If you vote for Biden, your kids will not be in school. He wants to shut it down. He was saying the other day, just said, oh, we'll shut it down. Hey, it is devastating for our nation. And we did just the right thing. We closed it down. We understood the disease. It affects, like, as an example, me. Guess who had it? I should not be here next year. In fact, this rally, usually we set up the rally. We don't call rallies anymore. We call friendly protests because you're allowed to protest, but you're not allowed to go to church. You're not allowed to have dinner with your friends. You can't do it. Right? You can't do it. So we call everything a protest. So we have no problem. And we have states where you can only protest. You can't do anything else. So we canceled those that had the idea. I said, wait a minute, let's just call it a protest. And everybody had a lot of people there. Sleepy Joe, there'd be no graduations, no weddings, no Thanksgiving. They're already talking about
that. I'm going to be after this. I'll get out of your way again.
And in California, you have a special mask. You cannot, under any circumstances, take it off. You have to eat through the mask. Right? But Charlie, it's a very complex mechanism. I never realized those germs, they go through it like that. They look at you with that contraption and they say, that's an easy one, I'm going to run through with the flu. Now, how about California, though, where you're supposed to eat with the mask? You see people? And boy, you know, when you have spaghetti and meat sauce, that mask is not looking
good.
You walk out and see me like you got into a fight with Dana White. You fought one of Dana White. I saw Dana White. Does anybody know Dana White? Looks like he got into a fight with one of his fighters, right?
Yeah. We've still got, hey mate, we've still got about 5 minutes.
By the way, just so you know, On November 4th, Philadelphia State is...
We're in the middle of a press crew, right?
On November 4th,
we're all here, right?
Yeah, that's why we got here early and got our spot.
General mortality is way down and way better than Europe and other places. All sorts of things are happening with the therapies, the therapeutics, cures. I think maybe a cure. I wasn't feeling great. And I was surrounded by doctors. And they gave me something, and the next day, I felt I could take any, I could take this guy to fight. No problem. And Sleepy Joe, I don't think Sleepy Joe would be a good fighter. One gentle little touch to the face, and he's down. He's down, and he wouldn't get up right away. Joe Biden's only idea. Remember, he said, I'd like to take him to the back of the line. Okay. Now, if I ever said that to him, they'd say, he practices violence. The president practices violence. No, that's right. Remember, he said, I would take him to the back of the line. That's like, if you have to fight somebody, that's your dream fight. Sleepy Joe. This guy never loses. They had something, because I'm doing 3-4 of these a day, and you think that's easy, right? The sun is blazing, the wind is going crazy. I did one last night in Michigan. It was about 30 degrees. And it was raining, and the rain was going into sideways, like one of these shots. We had an incredible crowd of people. Because, you know, they're all great. They're all like us. They love our country. That would be a tough one. And look what we've done for this one here. Both of you, from both of your states. The Biden. These guys, yeah, that's right. He's the White House doctor. sir, Baron is testing positive, sir. I'm sorry, I'm frightened. I said, what does that mean? Positive for what?
God.
For COVID. Well, you don't have the 30 days. The China virus, the plague, whatever. The plague from China, but the reactor. Baron is testing positive. And I said, that's too bad. Like, 2 minutes later, I said, how's Baron doing? Oh, it's okay, it's all gone. 99.9%. I'm working to make the breakthrough treatment that I received, and what we're going to do is we're making it, as I had a thing called Regeneron. We're going to make it available to anybody that needs it free. I don't know if it helped me or is it just a power. You know, I made a statement. I made a statement and they took it very seriously. CNN, fake news, total fake news. And I got better very quickly and I said, well, I should, because I'm a perfect physical specimen and I'm very young. They went crazy. He is not young and he is not a perfect specimen. They went crazy. They have no sense of humor whatsoever. Thanks to our relentless efforts, 97% of all emergency room visits, 97% are for something other than the virus. Think of that. Because we understand it now. We understand. People are getting better. And you know you're immune. That's why I could jump right there. See those men? I'll kiss them, man. I will kiss every man there. Kiss every woman there if you don't mind us. They won't catch anything, and you know what, I won't catch anything. And until I came along, right, they said, if you have it, you get better, you're immune for life. But when I said, I had it, I get better, they said, you've only got 4 months. They've changed the whole medical standard. It was anybody else who was good for life, right? But with me, they said, I'm now good for 4 months. I think it's a much longer. We're on track to deliver 100 million doses of a really great, safe vaccine. We have some of the greatest companies in the world that are ready to do stuff. And if I weren't president, if you had Sleepy Joe as your president, it would have taken you 4 years to have a vaccine. You would have never had a vaccine. What we did with the FDA, we said, sir, we'll need approximately 2 years. I said, how about 1 week? We moved up the schedule, and yet very, very soon, we will vanquish the virus. And emerge stronger than ever before. Our country will be stronger than ever before. And what I did, only because of you and the double state, with the double treatment, we spent a lot of money. We now have a new little thing. We have a big board that shows
the footprint.
And here's some of the governors talking about the incredible job we did on COVID for the China virus. Take a look.
The fact is, every time I called the president, he's quickly gotten on the line. When we asked to get support for that mercy ship in Southern California, he was able to correct that in real time.
What the federal government did, working with states, was a phenomenal accomplishment.
We got 2,000 of these field medical sites that are almost all operational now in the state because of his support. Those are the facts.
His team has been on it. I know a team when they're on it.
Yes, he is. And in fact, he's pretty relaxed.
His team is on it.
In response to the crowd here at
late at night, early in the morning, we are working very well with FEMA Region 2 and with the Army Corps of Engineers, building 4 field hospitals. That was a decision the president himself took, and I'm grateful for it. These were just extraordinary efforts and acts of mobilization. And the federal government stepped up. We needed help and they were there.
He said everything that I could have hoped for. And we had a very long conversation. And every single thing he said, they followed through.
We have had double the number of ventilators that we requested for that area of the state. And in fact, we got them in, frankly, short order.
Have we lost anyone
leading the Democrat
because we didn't have a bed, or we didn't have a ventilator, or we didn't have healthcare staff?
No. The president was extending support for new swabs. So conversation, commitment, promise made, promise kept.
maybe Biden's not telling us because he's forgotten his own plans. Watch Biden's staff quickly swoop in to shuffle him along during a quickie escape the basement trip to Pennsylvania.
Okay, here's the deal. One of the things that is important is that keep in mind, although they're going to vote on
that was terrifying.
What kind of country we're going to be? 4 more years of we're going to find ourselves in a position where if Trump gets elected, we're going to be in a different world.
56% of Americans said that they were better off today than they were 4 years ago would have been under the Obama-Biden administration. So why should people who feel that they are better off today under the Trump administration vote for you?
Well, if they think that, they probably shouldn't.
54% of American people are better off economically today than they were in our administration. Well, their memory is not very good, quite frankly.
A few moments later.
I'm running as a proud Democrat for the Senate. So, visitiowa.com/Ohio.
The guy in Dublin, we're running again. The senator was a Mormon. The governor, okay? Well, their memory is not very good, quite frankly.
If you were here with you today, it's that one thank the people of Ohio for being with you. He's done that 7 different times. And once you do that, it's over. Just walk off the stage, you can never make a good speech. Nobody's going to go home and say that was a great speech, except for the fact that he called us the wrong state. Joe Biden has surrendered his party to the rage-filled socialists, Marxists, and left-wing extremists. And that's what you're going to have. And you can't let it happen. The Democrats have spent the entire year inciting violence, hatred, and hatred against our police. Last night, the city of Philadelphia was ransacked by violent mobs and Biden-supported people. These were Biden-supported people. And he wouldn't even call them out. This morning, they said, please call them out. He's going to get radical left. Stores were looted, police cars were burned, and dozens of officers, great officers, were in. Biden and Harris stand up, and they stand with the riders of the vandals. I stand with the heroes of law. It took generations to build the America we know and love. But if the radical left gains power, it will take them only a short period of time to destroy it. This election day, you must stop the anti-American crazy radicals. They are controlled. That's why I say this is the most important election. I never thought I'd say this. But big tech will not allow that to be said, and the media will not say it. What he has done is horrible. The money from China, from Ukraine, from Russia, the wife of the mayor of Moscow gave him $3.5 million to son. The son had no job, no nothing. And $3.5 million, they put him on the board of understand a $3 million upfront payment. I think they could have from us. China gave him $1.5 billion to manage. You know, he's never managed money before. I asked people on Wall Street, is that common? They said, it's not common even for us. They don't do that. And that was after a meeting that lasted 10 minutes, flew in with his father in Air Force Two, flew back with $1.5 billion to manage from China. And then the big one, and I guess this one maybe got caught. I give a lot of credit for that story. Tucker Carlson. Jesse Griff. You know, we have a lot of good support. But the problem is, we can't have a lot. Because look at all those people up there. Every one of them, you know, they turn their camera off if I even talk about it. They turn their camera off. If I mention Biden corruption, they turn their camera off. And yet they'll do stories about me left and right, stuff that's so untrue. Over a telephone call. Congratulations on your victory, President. But we had good stick with the Republicans. The Republicans get by in Congress 197-0. How about that? Last night in that hour-long interview, the Biden family business partner revealed the depth and extent of Biden corruption. And you know, if you walk out your vice president and your son walks out with $100 million, and he's got no real capability, I would say that's corrupt. But y'all got a piece, right? For the big guy, right? They say we're going to keep 10% for the big guy. They call him the big guy. I don't think so. Joe was personally involved in establishing corrupt business dealings with China. At the same time, he was letting China plunder our jobs and destroy our businesses, our factories, our workers. Another report showed that the executive of a Chinese company that paid the Bidens at least $5 million was under surveillance by the U.S. government as a likely Chinese spy. Is it all? You know, this is all documented. They won't repeat it. Can you imagine if I did this? I had a conversation. Congratulations on your victory. I never met the person. I called him up. One of my great people. Thank you very much. Let's call him. That's what he was. That's what he was. And I got a message. We went to the health institute. And they slid in my campaign before I won this ride. Let's see what happens. It's all safe. And by the way, Obama and Biden were all about it. Obama and Biden were all about it. If Biden wins, China wins because China will own the U.S. He's going to own the president. I know him well. He has not got the same problems that Biden has. He is a very sharp guy, very smart guy. All the United States, I've charged them millions and millions and millions of dollars in tariff. I gave $28 billion, thank you very much, China, to our farmers. Because they're when we win, you win, Arizona win, Nevada wins, and America wins. We're thrilled to be joined tonight by some really great friends of mine and their warriors and their fighting heart, your governor, Doug Ducey. Got you. You look great, Doug. Glad you opened up. Thank you very much. Are you doing well, Doug? Doing good? I'm going to be so late. I'll call Doug. Doug, how are we? Won by about 17 points. I said, that's not so bad.
Thank you, Doug. Good job. Great job.
Somebody's done a fantastic job in the the Senate, and she's respected by everybody there, including me. She could fly this plane to Asia, but I just saw her. Senator Martha McSally. Wait. So, you know, Martha's opponent wants to get rid of the Second Amendment. I don't think so. You know, if you're talking about nothing else, right? He wants to get his whole thing is he wants to get rid of the Second Amendment.
He can't let it out. Around the corner of the audience, he just went back behind it.
That's him. Yeah. And you could find those plays, right? He's the only one in this whole thing. Congressman Paul Gosar. Great job, my warrior. He's a warrior. Thank you. Great job. You're doing okay, right? Thank you. Congressional candidate Daniel Rotemar. Daniel Rotemar. He's a really smart guy. But don't mess with him. He was a professional wrestler. He's a big dude. Yeah, big dude. But I hear you're doing well. You're really doing well. That's good. And Jim Marchant. Jim, congratulations on being here. He's doing good, Dan. I think so, right? I hear two winners. Arizona GOP chair, who I've liked right from the beginning, Kelly Ward.
Oh. Now we're here.
I won't like her anymore. I'm going to sing you fire. But I hear we're doing well. Really well. You have no idea when you watch yourself in the fake news, you watch it the same. The real numbers are substantially up. And also, we're up in Nevada. We're worried about the governor because he's a political. He headed a political club. Some club in Nevada. He sent out millions of ballots. Enforcement watching in your state. It's illegal to do bad things. Nevada GOP chair, Michael McDonald. Michael. Okay, that's good. That's all good, right? It's really good. We have somebody else who's been a friend of mine for a long time, respected by everybody. Former Nevada Attorney General Adam Laxalt. Virginia, they sent in 500,000 phony applications. They had another one. Thousands of ballots were printed. They had one problem. They forgot to put the name President Donald Trump on the ballot. Of course, there's another problem. History says you don't win too many of those. No, it's very, very dishonest what's happening, but hopefully the courts will protect us. We had a big win, actually, yesterday in Wisconsin. The United States Supreme Court said, I'm sorry, we haven't elected yet. Some of these people in Nevada, they want to have the election, they want to have the count weeks after November 3rd. So let's all wait for the governor to count them up good, and how many is he going to add during that 2 weeks? A man who I've known for a long time. He's an incredible guy. He's a tough guy. He's respected like you wouldn't believe. Made a lot of money with something that he truly loves. UFC President Dana White. What a job he has. If there was ever a case for loving what you do, he sees these fighters who want to rip you apart and he goes up and he bites them up. And your friends, Dana's a good guest, and he has done a fantastic job at some of the highest ratings in television. Dana White, UFC. And another friend of mine who was treated very, very poorly by big tech, but he's smarter than all of them. And he figured this out a long time ago, and he's got a very successful book. It just came out, Charlie Kirk. tell you what, the wall, they kept saying, right, the Democrats, we don't need a wall, we need drones. That's all they want. They talked about drones. So that we can watch thousands of people pouring in.
Yeah.
We actually were all set. We had drones. We have such technology within this wall. We got exactly the wall that the Border Patrol wanted. And negotiated with them, but they didn't want to talk. They wanted steel, they wanted concrete inside the steel, they wanted pre-bar inside the concrete, we got everything. And they wanted wires all over the place. And you know the other thing that will never be obsolete? Walls and everything else is Joe Biden has pledged to have open borders. He even said, maybe we'll take down the wall, one of the biggest projects in the history. His plan will completely obliterate so many of the things that you want. He would do things that you would never have, that you would never accept. He will do things that are so far left that we're not going to talk about them today. He will do things that will destroy our country. This would trigger a tsunami of illegal immigration. They want to have free health care for all, free education for all. Everybody gets a lawyer. That's just what we want, is a new lawyer. Everybody. Everybody gets a lawyer. No, we can't have it. We can't have what he has. He's also pledged. And he pledges so strong, but the good news about him, he can pledge and about 5 hours later, we'll have no idea what the hell. The Washington Democrats continue to attack our wonderful members of ICE and the Border Patrol, more than half of whom are Hispanic Americans, and many of them are here today. And I'm very proud to receive the endorsement from some of the toughest people on earth. In fact, I think they can actually go to Dana, and some of them can be actually drivers in Dana. National ICE Council, the union representing our incredible ICE officers, and a man who's been a friend of mine for a long time. He's the head council president. Just got the endorsement, Chris Gray. Where's Chris? Some of your people that make you find it interesting. The goodest people from us. Thank you for all, and thank you for your service, because you do a fantastic job. Border Patrol does a fantastic job. These guys are going to the best, and they start swinging. I don't like that job. You don't want to go to the police. They grow up and they say, you know what, we have moved out of thousands and thousands of hardened criminals, horrible criminals, MS-13. We moved them the hell out of our country. As president, I will always stand, I will always stand, Chris, for the heroes of ICE and for Border Patrol. So see if we can tell everybody. We invested $2.5 trillion in the U.S. military, including nearly $1 billion to build the world's most advanced guided missile. You know where it's being built? Right here in Arizona. We also passed VA choice and VA accountability. We killed the leader of ISIS, al-Baghdadi. And we then took out the world's number one terrorist, Soleimani, is dead. He's dead. I withdrew from the last administration's disastrous Iran nuclear deal. I recognized the capital of Israel and opened the American embassy in Tel Aviv. And I also recognized Israeli sovereignty over the Golan Heights. And instead of having these horrible, ridiculous, endless wars in the Middle East, we're making peace. You see what's going on there? Nobel Peace Prize. sir. Yeah, you know, we're doing trade deals with the coast. They're killing each other. Decades and decades of killing each other. They want to make trade with us. Everybody wants the United States, especially. So I said, you know what, we'll make it here, but you guys have to stop killing each other. Don't be crazy. These guys get along. And they're getting along. Getting along. A vote for Republicans is a vote for safe communities and a vote for the American dream. Always remember, Abraham Lincoln, the great Abraham Lincoln, was a Republican. I could be more presidential than any president that's ever said, with the exception of perhaps Abraham Lincoln when he's wearing the hat. He's wearing the hat, he's wearing the hat. Over the next 4 years, we will make America into the manufacturing superpower of the world. And we will end our reliance on China once and for all. Opportunity zones, reduce your taxes, obliterate your regulations like we've done, nobody has ever done what we've done with regulations, and provide school choice to every parent in America. We will hire more police, increase penalties for assaults on law enforcement, and we will ban deadly sanctuary cities. We will defend the military. The right to life and the right to keep and bear arms. We will maintain America's unrivaled military might. Nobody has the equipment. We are the envy of the world militarily. Nobody has done. When I came the first week, I was told by one of the world's most overrated generals, sir, we have no ammunition. Now we have so much ammunition, we don't know what the hell we're doing. All made in the USA. All made in the USA. And we will ensure peace through strength. We will end, sir. Right? We will end surprise medical loan. Require price transparency. Lower drug prices. Look, we took drug prices. Last year was the first year in 52 years of price cap. Now I would vote for every nation to be more than any other nation in the world by far. Because farmers hate me, big farmers hate me. They are spending so much. And what I did is I made it favorite nations. The most expensive by far in the world. We now go down to the least expensive time. You'll have a 50, 60, 70, 80% reduction in drug prices. And I am not liked very much by those. So when you see those ads one after another, and next week each other look like peanuts compared to drug companies, nobody has more money, nobody's more powerful in terms of lobby. But I have no choice. I have to do what's right. I don't care. I have to do We will protect your Social Security and your Medicare, which Joe Biden, you saw that, Joe Biden tried to obliterate. And we will always protect patients with pre-existing conditions. America will land the first woman on the moon in the United States. We'll be the first nation to land an astronaut on Mars. Maybe we'll make that a woman. Maybe we should make that a woman too. He said, make it Nancy Pelosi, that's it. You said that, that's right.
Yeah, I think I am.
Stand up. he incites trouble. He loves trouble. Thank you very much. That was very good. Are you a comedian professionally? Great. We will stop the radical indoctrination of our students and restore patriotic education finally. Our children to love our country, honor our history, and always respect our great America. We live by the kindest words of our nation. In God we trust. You know, they tried to take the word God out of the Pledge of Allegiance. They did it once, I said, oh, they made a typo. And they did it a second time, they said, that's not a typo. Years you had a president who apologized for America. Now you have a president who is standing up for America. And standing up for the great people of Arizona and America. Thank you. Start crying to say the president was right. The president broke down into tears as they screamed, "We love you." From Tombstone to Preston, from Phoenix, it's like I have a good memory because you can't see the sun gets over like. Lucky I have a memory. You are so lucky, people, that I took you on this journey with me. I say it to all my people, where's Hope Machine? Does anyone know Hope? Miss Sova. Miss Jared is making peace in the Middle East. It's all the best about Hope Machine. Guy, I'll tell you, you don't get guys like that, but he's done a good job, but you have Jared. He's done the exact opposite of what they've been doing for 4 years, Mason here, and from Phoenix to right here, Bullhead. And suckers moving so much, I see. You did a great job of anchoring these things, fellas. You did a great job. This is what modern engine. All you have to do is put another two specs on it. We inherit the legacy of American patriots who poured out their heart, sweat, soul to secure our liberty and to defend our freedom. This great state was settled by some of the toughest men and strongest women ever to walk on earth. Arizona is where Wyatt Earp and Doc Holliday, how about that? Became American West. It's where the great American West became the American dream. And Arizona is the state where generations of pioneers and prospectors, miners, ranchers, cowboys, cattle hands, marshals, and lawmen paved the frontier, braved the blazing sun that I'm braving. They showed the entire world how the West was won. They helped make America into the greatest nation in the history of the world, and the best is yet to come. Now, citizens like you will build this country, and together we are taking back our country. We can't let it happen. You know, when that goes, when it goes, you know, it's going to be a mess. American people. And with your help, your devotion, and your drive, we are going to keep on working. We are going to keep on fighting. And we are going to keep on winning, winning, and winning. We are one movement, one people, one family, and one glorious nation under God. And together with the incredible people of Arizona and Nevada, we'll never forget that, Father. We're going to have a tremendous win. Are we going to win in Nevada, please? There are a lot of people here. A lot of people from Nevada, too. We have made America powerful again. We have made America wealthy again. We have made America strong again. We have made America proud again. We have made America safe again. And we will make America great again.
We'll be right back. all this.